Wow, that's very close to being set on fire. Whoa. Next time you go to the toilets.
You're a good deal. I could just go home.
Alone again, naturally. In a little while from now, if I'm not feeling any less sour, I promise myself to treat myself and visit a nearby tower. And climbing to the top will throw myself off in an effort to make it clear to whoever what it's like when you're shattered, like standing in the lurch at a church where people saying, my God, that's tough, she stood him up. No point in us remaining, may as well go home, as I did on my own, alone again, naturally. Think that only yesterday I was cheerful, bright and gay, looking forward to, well, it wouldn't do, the role I was about to play. But as if to knock me down, reality came around, and without so much as a mere touch, cut me into little pieces, leaving me to doubt of about God and His mercy, or if He really does exist. Why did He desert me in my hour of need? I truly am indeed alone again, naturally. It seems to me that there are more hearts broken in the world that can't be mended, left unattended. What do we do? What do we do? Now looking back over the years and whatever else that appears, I remember I cried when my father died, never wishing to hide the tears. And at 65 years old, my mother, God bless her soul, couldn't understand why the only man she had ever loved had been taken, leaving her to start with a heart so badly broken. Despite encouragement from me, no words were ever spoken. When she passed away, I cried and cried all day, alone again, naturally. Alone again, naturally. Happy Yuletide festivities. Lovely. That's great.